What if you could design stunning presentations, websites, and social media posts all in minutes without ever touching a design template again? Well, that's exactly what Gamma helps you do. Hi, I'm Kevin, and in this video, in partnership with Gamma, we'll look at how you can design everything from slides to websites to social content so you could spend less time formatting and more time focusing on what you do best. Let's dive in. First off, head to the following website. You'll find a link at the bottom of the screen. Once you land on the homepage, you can set up a free account if you don't already have one. Simply click here. I'll see you on the other side. Once you finish signing up for Gamma, you'll land here on the Create screen, and you're greeted with three different ways to get started. Now, over here, first, you can paste in text. And this is perfect if, let's say, you already have notes, an outline, or maybe some draft content that you want to transform into something beautiful. Let's go back. Over on the right-hand side, you could also import a file or a URL. So maybe you're already working on something. You could then import that in. That lets you enhance existing documents, presentations, or even web pages using Gamma's design power. Let's go back again. Right here in the center, you also have the option to generate. And this also happens to be Gamma's most popular option. Here, all you have to do is write a simple one-line prompt. As an example, create a sales presentation for, say, a new cookie delivery service, and then Gamma will build everything for you in just a few seconds. Let's click on this one. This drops us into generate, and this is where we can tell Gamma exactly what we want to build. At the top, we have a few different output types to choose from: a presentation, a web page, a document, or a social post. I need to build a presentation for our brand new Kevin Cookie Company subscription box, in which case, I'll make sure to select presentation. Right here, I'll leave the number of cards set to 8, which you could think of just like slides in a typical presentation. So this will give us a nice short deck to work with. And right here, this is where the magic happens. You just type in a simple description of what you want. So let's go with something like, create a pitch deck for the Kevin Cookie Company's new monthly cookie subscription box, featuring product benefits, pricing, and how to sign up. Then, right down below, let's hit Generate Outline to see what Gamma comes up with. And just like that, Gamma has created a full 8-card outline for our presentation. Right at the top, you'll see that it kicks off with a high-level overview of this new service. Then we talk about the cookie box experience, the customer benefits, subscription options, business benefits, and it goes on and on. And we have 8 different cards. Again, these cards are like slides in a traditional presentation. So this deck is basically ready to go. Of course, I could always click in and I could make edits to the different cards. As an example, here we say the cookie box experience, but maybe instead of saying that, I'd like to say the ultimate cookie box experience. And if we scroll down just a little bit more, here we talk about customer benefits, and I think I'd like to follow that card with all of the business benefits. I can press and hold on this card, and here I can move it to a new position. That way we talk about it right after. And if I scroll down, I think all of the rest of this looks good. If we scroll down just a little bit more, Gamma gives you full control over the look and feel of your presentation. Here you'll see a few different themes that you can choose from. And in fact, right up here, you can also view an entire collection of even more themes. Now, right now it's set to the default of Oasis, and I think that looks fine, so I'll stick with this. But you can always come in later on and you can change your selection. So don't feel like you're locked in if you choose something. I can also adjust how much text appears on each slide or card of my presentation, all the way from brief to very detailed, depending on how much info you want Gamma to show. Now, I've always heard that brief is better for a presentation, so I'll choose this. And right below that, you'll notice that Gamma gives me full control over the images that it uses in this presentation. By default, it's set to AI images, which is actually perfect here since this is a brand new product and I don't have any real photos yet. Gamma can generate visuals that help bring the cookie subscription concept to life. Now, right here, you also have other options. Over here, you could use stock photos, web images, illustrations, animated GIFs, and if you have your own images that you would like to use, you could have Gamma insert in image placeholders. Again, I think AI images will work great for this, and it's also really neat to showcase what Gamma can do. I'll select this option. And if you want to set a specific visual style, you could describe it right here. For example, the color palette, the mood for the images. Gamma will use AI to generate matching visuals automatically. I'll type in some text for the Kevin Cookie Company. Most importantly, I'd like to make sure that it uses the blue and gold primary colors that we include in all of our marketing materials. Lastly, Gamma also lets you choose the AI image model that generates the visuals if you chose to have AI generate images. By default, it's set to Ideogram 3 Turbo, which I found is great for creating realistic and also creative images. Now, you could leave it as is, or you could also explore some of the other options. When you hover over, you can see a sample image as well as what it's good for. Lots of different options here. Now, I'm good sticking with the default, so I'll select this. Now, down at the very bottom, let's hit the generate button and we can watch this presentation come to life. And here it is. Gamma just designed a complete presentation for the new Kevin Cookie Company subscription box. Let's jump to the top of the presentation. Over on the left-hand side, I can see all of my different cards or slides. To navigate through, simply click on the card that you would like to go to. I'll click on the first one, and that brings me to the top of the presentation. Let's now look at what it pulled together. Every card includes a nice headline. And look at this beautiful visual. It even matches our brand colors, the signature blue, and also the gold packaging. That's exactly the kind of visual that I'd want to include in a real product launch. Now, each slide here is fully formatted. Here we have a nice headline. We have nice benefits and visuals. Now, over on the left-hand side, let's jump down to the sign-up process. And look at this, it even includes a flowchart diagram to match the content of this slide. And here, if we jump all the way down to the end, here we have another beautiful image. And here it's talking about the timeline. And so it includes a timeline visual. It's really perfect. Now, of course, I'll need to modify some of the text and some of the points included on these different slides, and maybe even some of the visuals. But honestly, this is a much easier place to start than just staring at a blank canvas. Instead of focusing on the design and the presentation, I could spend my time on the content. Now, let's go back up to the top and let's start by making a few tweaks. As you'd expect, you could simply click in and start making edits. As an example, here in the first slide, we say that the launch is coming up in June 2025. I mean, that's only next month. We're going to need to buy ourselves a little bit more time than that. I'll click on June and instead let's type in October. As much as I like this image over on the right-hand side, it doesn't actually say the Kevin Cookie Company on it. That might concern our investors. So here, I'll simply click on this image, and then I get this overlay down below. And I can ask AI to make modifications to this image. I'll click on this. I have a few different options, but at the very top, I can also ask a specific question. Let's see if we can make a product box full of cookies that includes text saying Kevin Cookie Company Club. And then here again, we also want to make sure that we use the blue and gold color scheme. And let's simply press enter. Wow, check that out. I get four options down below. Here, I get the same image, but this time including the Kevin Cookie Company Club text. And here I have three other entirely new options. That one looks pretty good. Let's see this one. Wow, look at those cookies. They look delicious. And here's the last one. I think I like this the best. That looks like a true cookie glamour shot. If you would like even more control, over here we can click on the image and right down below we can now edit the image. This opens up a pane and here we can see the specific prompt that was used to generate this image. You can go in and you can modify it. Down below you can choose the style and here you can choose the aspect ratio and even you can modify the model on an individual image level. Then you can try regenerating your image. However, I'm really happy with how this image turned out, so no need to make any additional changes. In the top right, I'll close out of this pane. Let's now take a look to see if there are any other images that we would like to update in this presentation. Ooh, here we have a photo of our beautiful packaging, but unfortunately, it's in front of a somewhat sterile background. We have this white coffee table with a really bright background. To make modifications to this image, I'll simply double-click on it. And here, over on the right-hand side, in the chat with AI, we see that it's now focused on this image. Here I have a few different preset options, but I could also type in exactly what I would like to change. I want to update the background. Now, I think it'll work a lot better if we have some type of rustic wooden coffee table and maybe a fireplace in the back just to give that really warm feel. Let's see if I can make this update. Let's send the request. Whoa, these are some nice options. Here I have the original image, but in a new location. And here I have three entirely new options. I think this one goes along better with the intro slide image. So let's select this. Now I think one thing that's missing is it would be nice to include a glass of milk. Let's see if I can make one additional modification. Let's send that. Nice, look at that. It looks like the text is just a little bit off. So let's see if we could fix that. Let's make sure that it includes this text and let's try modifying. It now gives me a few new options and it looks like in all of them, the text is spelled correctly. This one works perfectly. Something feels a little off. I'd like this presentation to be just a little bit more upbeat and maybe brighter. And I think that has something to do with the theme. Right up on top, you can always go back in and change your theme. I'll click on this and let's scroll down the list to see if something really stands out. Ooh, I like cornfield. That looks really happy and upbeat. Yes, that's exactly what I'm looking for. Over on the right-hand side, let's close out of the theme pane. At this point, it wouldn't be a real company presentation if we didn't include a slide where we let investors meet the team. To add a new slide, right over here, I'll click on this icon and I can add a new card or slide using AI. Let's try this. Down below, let's describe the type of card that we would like to add. Please add a Meet Our Team card to this presentation and let's enter that. And just like that, we now have a new card that introduces our cookie subscription team. This is a really nice design. If you'd like to make tweaks to this card, right up above, we could click on this icon to edit with AI. Over here, we can edit the text, or we could even test out an entirely new layout. When I click on this, over on the right-hand side, it opens up a pane, and then it generates additional AI layouts. Here, we could preview a few of the different options. Here, we show the entire team. Here, we have another picture of the whole team, and a few other options. I think I like the original one, so I'll click on that, and let's stick with this. Up on top, I'll close this pane. Just like we've been doing, I can modify all these different images. I can modify the text. The good thing is I don't have to start from a blank slide. I currently have the Meet the Team card as the second card in my presentation. I don't think that makes sense. I think it would fit better at the very end. So over here, I'll press and hold on this card and I can drag it all the way down to the bottom. I'll place it right there at the very end. Along with using AI to modify your cards and the content within those cards, you also have full manual control. Over on the right-hand side, you can insert what's called a block onto a card. As an example, I could click into basic blocks and here we have text, tables, lists, and more. Over here, you could insert images. We also have videos and media. You could even insert one of my YouTube videos. Over here, we also can embed different apps. Over here, charts and diagrams. And lastly, we also have forms and buttons. Let's say as an example, I'd like to offer a way for people to learn more about Sarah Thompson, our program director. Over here, I could insert a button. I could simply press and hold on this and then drag it to where I would like to insert this button on the card. I'll place it, let's say right down here at the bottom of Sarah Thompson. Then over here, I could enter in a link and I could also modify the text. Let's say learn more. Now I could click away and that looks nice. This presentation is looking sharp and I think I'm ready to present this out to the broader team. Over on the left-hand side, let's go back to the first slide. To present this, I don't have to download anything. In the top right-hand corner, I'll simply click on present. This drops me into presentation mode. To navigate through my presentation, I could simply use the arrow keys and look at those nice subtle animations that appear for the images and the text coming in. That looks so beautiful. To exit out of presentation mode, simply press the escape key on your keyboard. Along with presenting my deck, I can also just share it with others. Over here, let's click on share. Here, we have lots of different options. You can invite people to collaborate with you on this deck. Right over here, you could also share out a link with others. You could export it. Let's say you'd like a PDF, a PowerPoint presentation, or even a new item, Google Slides. And right up here, you could even embed your presentation directly into a website. One of my favorite features, down at the bottom, you can also view analytics. That way you can see how many people make it through your entire presentation and what cards people end up engaging with the most. Over here, let's close out of this view. Now that we're done creating, let's go back into the main Gamma workspace. In the top left-hand corner, let's click on this home icon. This brings us to the main workspace. And here you can see all of your different projects or what they like to call gammas, and you can get back to them very quickly. Right up on top, you have different filtering options and you could also sort the view. Up at the very top, you can also create a new gamma. Here you could also start from blank or you could import existing content in. The way I like to think of it, it's basically like your own personal cookie jar. Except, not with cookies, but here with all of your different projects and ideas. And that's it. Now, of course, I'll have to go in and update all the details, but the overall deck is looking fantastic. My manager will be so impressed. Check it out for yourself. Link in the description. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a cookie subscription business that I need to launch.